Hi and welcome back to the channel UiPath with Jeppe. Today we're talking about the Automation Express user license type that can be used for personal automation. And we'll just take a quick look at some of the capabilities, then I'll show you how to set it up, and then I'll talk a little bit more about some of the implications of this license type, because this really could be a game changer. So let's get to it. So here in the webpage describing the license type, we can see that what you can do with the Automation Express license type is you get access to Studio X and Studio Web. You can only publish automations to your personal workspace when using Studio X. And you also get limited access to the functionality in the Automation Cloud and also slight limitations in the UiPath Assistant. But let's try and set up a new user with this new license type and see how it works in the real world. Okay, I'm inside of my cloud platform here. And in this platform, basically, what we have, if we go into the admin and accounts and groups page, is we can see there's only one user in here, and we're going to invite another user into the platform. Before we do that, we just go to the groups tab up here, and we can see that there's also a new group called Automation Express. And if we take a look at the license allocation for this group, we can see that members of this group will automatically be given an Automation Express license. So we'll just cancel back out, go to the users and group tab and invite a new user. And the new user is going to be Julie. And we are going to assign her to the Automation Express user group and click the invite button. And we'll close. So now we have sent an invite to Julie, and Julie doesn't even have an account in the UiPath platform yet. But we'll go to Julie's email and we'll just press 5, and we should see an invite to join the UiPath Automation Cloud platform here. And we've been invited to join, and we will on Julie's behalf click accept the invite. And because Julie doesn't have an account in the UiPath Automation Cloud, we will need to create a new user account for her. We will do that here, and we will use her email to create the account. And we can see it already filled out her email address. And we will enter a password for her. And now, because Julie is brand new to the UiPath platform, we will need to enter a verification code. We can find that by going to her email again, pressing F5, and we should get the verification code. I will enter that into the fields here. And also we will enter her full name into these boxes. We will just call her Julie the Tester and click Next. And there we go. It says, good afternoon, Julie the Tester. We have now joined Julie into the automation platform. And what we can do now then is we can minimize the browser. And if I start up UiPath Studio, a couple of things are going to happen. It's going to ask us to sign into Studio. Now we are already signed in the browser, so it's actually probably going to know once I click this sign in button that we are Julie right now. Let's see what happens. It does. It recognizes us as Julie already. And what happens now is both the UiPath Studio signs in to her account, and also the UiPath Assistant over here on the right signs in. So now again, I'll minimize the browser, maximize Studio, and we create a new project. And we'll just create a very, very simple project. We'll just call it Tester. Create. And we can start building our automation. So we'll just do a very simple one with a message box. And say, hello world. Click save. And now if I just resize Studio a little bit here and run the automation, we'll see it run over here on the right inside of UiPath Assistant. It's not going to be installed into the assistant because we haven't published this automation yet, but we should see it run over there in just a second, and we should now see it display a message box saying, hello world. There we go. And as soon as I click OK to end the automation, it's going to disappear from our UiPath Assistant. There we go. So it's not going to appear permanently over here until we actually do a publish. So we're going to do that now. And when we go to the next publishing options here, we can see that we only have the option of publishing it to the Orchestrator Personal Workspace feed. And this is really one of the main limitations of this Automation Express license, is you can only publish to the personal feed. So if we do that, it'll publish in just a few seconds. Like that. And if we go over to the UiPath Assistant, press refresh, we can now see the tester automation has been made available over here. If we minimize Studio and press play, it's going to install the tester for real and then run it and display the message box. And when we press OK, it's going to stay over here because now we've actually published and installed it as an automation inside of our UiPath Assistant. So what does all of this mean? Well, first of all, this is free. This is free for real free. So you can use the Automation Express license for free, even for commercial purposes. You know, a couple of years ago, a competing product, let's call it that, came out and said, we have a desktop automation tool that is free for all Windows users. Well, UiPath has that as well now. It's completely free. You can use it commercially, but with the limitation that it is only meant for attended robots in your personal workspace. And this is, by the way, completely in line with that competing product. So this is really a game changer for UiPath as far as citizen development goes and personal desktop automation goes. So this table here displays a lot of information about the different licensing plans. But if we go down to the user licenses part, what we can see is that with all plans except the community edition, the free plan, the pro plan, and the enterprise plan, with all of these plans, you get quite a few of these licenses included for free. So if you are working on an enterprise plan right now with a client or as an organization, you now have 100 free Automation Express licenses that you can distribute to users in the organization and let them build automations for themselves. And I cannot believe that this has not made any kind of headlines, because this is a big deal compared to where UiPath licensing for end user automation was just a few months ago. So make sure you make use of these free licenses, either in your own organization or if you're working with clients in their organizations. So that's it for this time. If you want to hear more about licensing, let me know and I'll try to make a video about licensing in general. Other than that, I can promise you I will be releasing a lot more Studio X videos in the future. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, ask them in the comments below. So that's it for now. Take care. Stay safe. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.